Day you thought would never come, the open D-Fender is here. So when we reduce the wide, you could see some very, very small eyelets here at the chainstay, monostay, and at the bottom of the fork, completely invisible really, also here on the back of the seatstay, monostay. But no mounts or anything, no eyelets on the fork or near the rear dropouts. And the reason that is that for the D-Fender, we use these. Our friends at Carbon Tie make this very beautiful, very light, thin axle for us. And the beauty of these things is that they fit through the through axles that Carbon Tie also makes for us. So you don't need any eyelets here because you just have this axle that goes through the through axle, and then, you know, the stays mount, fire these breakaway points to our axle. There's some spaces in between to make sure that you know, the paint doesn't get damaged, and to keep enough clearance for your brake calipers. And then the fender blades, the wires, the breakaways, all these pieces are made by SKS in Germany, so it's made quite locally. And all you have to do is you mount your fender, you know, to the inserts back and front, and then put the axles through, tighten it down, and you get yourself a very nice solution for wet days. Now, it should be noted that with any fender, there's always a recommendation of 15 millimeters of clearance between the fender and the tire, and to basically use tires that don't have a lot of profile. I mean, if you go with a very extreme tire, you go into the forest, you're gonna get dirty anyways. There's no point using a fender. So the fenders are really meant mostly for that commuting ride, right? So maybe you have a 35 millimeter 700C tire, and it's more a road tire or with some small profile, then it works great. But always make sure you adhere to the safety guidelines. Speaking of that, you'll find the manual in the shipment when you order the fenders. You can also download it, of course, from our site, and always make sure you follow those guidelines. So I hope you like what we've done, and it also means, as you know, that when you remove the fenders, there's really nothing visible on the frame. It's just a very clean setup. So let's go ride in the rain.